today. From Empower Field at Mile High in Denver, it's week two of the NFL on EA Sports.
We find ourselves at the foot of the Rockies, Denver, Colorado, for this edition of the NFL on EA Sports. Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the New York Jets and the Denver Broncos. And this carries into the end zone. And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25. So now here comes the Jet offense as they get ready to take over. As we take a peek at Sam Darnold, the former USC Trojan and third pick in the 2018 draft.
I love how he exploded on the national scene his redshirt freshman year when, at the beginning of the season, he was not named the starting quarterback. But when USC was struggling, he got an opportunity. And by the end of the year, the Rose Bowl MVP, an epic shootout with Penn State, and put him on the NFL radar in a big way.
And they'll run the option to start the drive. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. Second and six, just inside the 30.
It's now second and six at the 29-yard line.
To throw is Darnold. Rush coming, and he's taken down.
A loss of 3 yards. It's third.
The competition comes up in so many different ways, and right now, this unit, their competition is who's going to get to the quarterback the most times. They got 5 sacks last week. We just saw their first one of this game.
Throwing here on third down, Darnold. And this is going to be incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. Pretty good punt there, but also a nice return of 12 yards. And the Broncos take over, first down and 10. So now here are the Broncos for their first drive of the game. And leading them out there, we get a look at their 6'3 quarterback.
I read something prepping for this game that he said prior to, and I think he really said it a few months ago, where he talked about he wants to have the type of season that at the end, he's buying gifts for all the guys who helped him along the way. And I know that the team wants to.
It's a foot race.
Uh-oh.
And all the way home for the Broncos score. There, Phillip Lindsay, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Broncos have taken the early lead. Both sides of the football in sync early. You force the three and out, and then you take it down, score points.
You know what that tells me? They sold their game plan really well. Head coach said, listen, we're just going to stop them on three and out. We're going to take the ball downfield and score. But he also told them how it was going to happen. They're going to run this, we're going to stop it. Then we're going to take the ball, they won't be able to keep up with us. And they got it done.
Extra point from McManus is good. And that makes the score 7-0.
McManus to kick off for Denver.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And a three and out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out a little extra emotion. So now they get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive.
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity. Nothing big happened. But then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go.
Give them 14 on that one and a first down. Now a draw play. This is Bell. And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
On the tackle.
The numbers for Bell on the ground of the game last week. 23 carries, 99 yards.
They've got a nice scheme going right now, and they run the football pretty well. In fact, I was talking with him on the field before the game, and he said he's starting to hear from the guys ahead of him on the rushing yardage total, and they want to know
intercepted. Picked off by Bryce Callahan.
All day.
And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Bronco defense has a touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Now McManus for the extra point. And it's good, and they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away.
And this carries into the end zone, and this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
This Jets offense heading back out there now, led by Sam Darnold. And now, Charles, this becomes a pretty important second drive for them. They're already down a pair. And the Broncos get there and take him down.
The pass rush has been a real strength of late. They know how to get out to the quarterback.
Absolutely. Four sacks last week. That's their first one here. Anything in particular you've seen from them or on film?
I think that they're winning athletically up front, winning those one-on-one battles. But also, when the offensive line wants to keep everyone in and mass protect, they know how to scheme their way back to the quarterback as well.
It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up the third down. From the gun on third down, here's Darnold. And that is incomplete.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
So possession goes over here on the punt. And that will come the offense as they take over.
4-yard line.
Denver offense at the line, ready to go. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it big time, John? Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play action pass could very well be open.
4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
Well, Charles, we get a look at the draft class here for this team. What do you think?
Well, I think for the most part, I do like what they did, because to me, they got some solid players in the early rounds. And then if I'm correct in my evaluation, they got some great value in the later rounds as well.
And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
That's good.
That third down conversion, good for 23. So in Jet territory now. Here's first and 10 as they've got it to the 28-yard line. Now a carry for Lindsey. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and 2.
Brings up second and 2.
A run with Lindsey out of the gun. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line.
That's good.
They came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football.
First down.
I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
On first and 10, it's Lindsey. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6.
He was brought down.
Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
And inches at the 6-yard line.
From the gun, Larson toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. K.J. Hamler, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
Marcus Peters on the coverage.
Operating from the gun, Larson. And the Jets defense making things difficult there. Fourth down, Vic Fangio, an old school coach, but he's going to go for it here on fourth.
Marcus Peters.
They're going with Lindsey. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. 4 yards on the pickup. And the decision to go for it pays off. They've got a first and goal. And they'll turn their power game to try to get in. Stop short. Down at the 1. Had the great move, but couldn't get all the way to the end zone. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal. Take it into the end zone for a Denver score. A great play there. His first touchdown of the new season. And the Broncos will extend their lead.
Boy, these guys are off to the races.
races, Charles. 20-0 already, extra point pending.
Yeah, you always hear that term, they just boat race someone. Heck, it's car race, motorcycle race, plane race, whatever you want. Right now, they are sprinting past
him. McManus' point after is good, and that makes the score 21-0.
Brandon
after the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And some dangerous territory. You're already down three scores. A three and out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
Darnold off the play fake to Bell. And his throw is incomplete. Hayden Hurst, former first-round pick, the intended target. And it's third down.
Third down and 7 yards to go.
A shotgun snap for Darnold. Trying to get it to Robinson, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Bryce Callahan. And a terrific return as he takes this thing all the way down near the 20-yard line.
Darnold. And that's now the second time he's picked off a pass here in the first half alone. Again, another great read defensively. And you just see him get in the right position to make the play and get his guys the football back.
So here are the Broncos to take over on offense. They defeated the Patriots last week. Now looking to make it two in a row here as they come up first and 10. Throwing to start the drive. Larson, screen pass to Lindsey. And they got it inside the 10 at the 8. Sets him up nicely. First and goal. It was a pickup of 14.
First and goal at the 8.
They'll run with Lindsey. Yeah, the Broncos are going to have it first and goal as they'll take this down to about the 3. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one. And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, C.J. Mosley. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
At their own 4-yard line.
They'll start out on the ground with Bell. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And that'll make this a 2nd and 13. Now Bell. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Call it no gain there. Now they're looking at a 3rd and 13.
No gain on the play. And it's 3rd down.
Here's Bell. And some room to work. And he gets up near the 25 to about the 24 before going out of bounds. Able to convert on 3rd and 14. A terrific play call. Now after the run by Bell, here's another 1st and 10. And they'll try the air now with Darnold. Short throw underneath to Hurst. They'll contain him to just 4. 2nd down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. The Jets on 3rd down, just 1 for 5 to this point. They're looking at 3rd in the nose of the football. Back to the ground, this time with Bell. And he will have a 1st down as they get him to the ground at the 37.
Down by Vaughn.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
And they will only muster a yard here to the 38.
The tackle made.
The run only got a yard. Here's 2nd and 9.
A gain of a yard. Brings up 2nd and the 38.
Hand off here to his running back. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
And Darnold going to be intercepted for the third time. He's picked off just shy of midfield. There he goes outside. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Bronco defense has a touchdown. A big play there by the rookie. An interception followed by the return for 6 points.
If you want to be accepted by your teammates and coaching staff, make plays like that.
Now for the extra point. It's good, and they stretch their lead to 28-0 now. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six.
Brendan McManus to kick off.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
Back on offense, New York gets set to take over.
Now they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train?
Now Bell hit. He lost the football. It's picked up by the Broncos. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line.
They may have the edge on the scoreboard, but that hasn't made them pass it, has it? I mean, they dialed up a pretty good run blitz there. And Brandon, you know that all blitzes aren't just designed to get to the quarterback and the passer. Sometimes you're just trying to take away every gap, every hole. That might be created in a running game, and they did it to perfection and caused a fumble there.
Took away the gaps, took away the holes, took away the football, and able to get about three as he's taken down right at the 20. The last run got three. Now here's second and seven.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks.
And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. A 20-yard touchdown. Continue to pull it on.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them play running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays right after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone.
To kick off for Denver.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Now the Broncos heading back out onto the field. And they have forced now 4 turnovers, Mr. Davis. How've they been so effective?
It's hard to get a read on them if you're on offense because they're coming from different angles, different formations, different looks. But bottom line is, if I'm the defensive coordinator, anything on my play sheet appears to be working right now. You point it out all the time when we call games. Once they get that first one, it becomes a frenzy, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's snowballed here in this one. Short throw underneath to Hurst. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. That catch good for only a couple. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. They'll break the huddle, come up on 2nd and 8 at the 27-yard line. The shotgun. Here's Darnold. Open man is Ross. Complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It's a first down on a gain of 10. It's brought in by Jamison Crowder. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. Crowder's got it over the middle. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Darnold to throw again to the right side and complete to Hurst. A gain of 6 there on first.
big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Throwing again on second down. Darnold, he's going to have the hook up to Ross. Now the Jets going to use the second of their three timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. Took nearly the entire first half, but a first red zone opportunity for him here. It's first and 10 from the 12. And not able to get it that time. He hit on six straight passes. Not there, second down.
It's now second and 10.
To the air again, Darnold. And it's caught. And the Jets are looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line.
New York.
It's a good gain of 11, sets him up first and goal. This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. Throwing again is Darnold. And he's got it. And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. Aiden Hurst, as the first half is winding down, as they are now on the board here in the first half. Good start to the season for him. He had the touchdown last week in the opener and a second one in week two now.
How about the pace he's already established, right? Not sure he can keep it up for an entire season, but don't burst the bubble because he thinks that he can.
Do guys go into a season with a goal for touchdown scored or yardage? What do you think?
I think every single one of the guys who's going to touch the football, they all have those types of goals. They all have those types of thoughts. Then they just have to see how the season unfolds if they can stay with it.
Unfolding so far, so good for him. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we're find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
It's a gain of 8. Brings up second.
8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And he's going to have a first down, but not sure it'll matter as the clock will continue to run. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Here's Lindsey, and he's dropped right at the 40, gain of 3. So we've come to halftime after a very one-sided beginning to this one. As we send you on out to our studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, we'll get you back to you and Charles in a bit, but first it's time for a trip around the NFL following an eventful opening weekend. Let's see what's happening in week two. We'll start out in Los Angeles, the City of Angels, visiting Pittsburgh in town to take on the Chargers. And it's the Chargers who are out in front. The Chargers hoping to get into the win column for the first time this year as they play in front of their home crowd. From there, we're off to check out another game. And they have the lead in that one over the visiting Raiders. Josh Allen has thrown a touchdown pass. Lastly, we head to Gillette Stadium in Foxborough to check on the Patriots. And they were winners in that game over the visiting Kansas City Chiefs. 21-7, the final score. Meanwhile, our game has been a boat race. Very one-sided to this point. And for the call of the second half, let's get it back to our commentating team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Broncos with a lead, and they will be receiving this kickoff here as quarter 3 is underway. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
At their own 23-yard line.
Denver offense at the line, ready to go. They had a big first half. Now they have a chance to add to that lead here in the opening possession of the second half.
And everyone always asks about halftime adjustments, kind of the key phrase. What did you do at halftime? Well, the way they ran offense in the first half, I think they were very calm, congratulatory, but also what they were saying, same on defense. They'll be the ones making the adjustments. Let's see what they do, and we'll attack accordingly.
And we'll see how they attack here. And he'll get this one up to the 26. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead.
It's third and seven.
To throw on third down, Larson. This is the tight end fan. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee. And that means fourth down. And in their own territory, needing only a few inches, they're going to line up to go for this thing on fourth down. Meeting the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. And he's going to have a Broncos first down as he's able to get this up past the 40. They only needed a few inches, but still some anxious moments there, but they do convert on fourth. And again, they'll go right back to their fullback. The linebacker, C.J. Mosley, in on the stop.
A good solid game there on first down, but the defense has to be happy. They didn't let it pop for anything bigger.
Second and six at the 45-yard line.
Looking to throw on second down. Larson, that's going to be caught by Judy.
Larson's pass.
That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down.
A gain of a yard on the play. Brings up third and four.
Back to throw. Larson. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he's got this down to the 35. That good for 19 yards as they pick up the conversion on third. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down.
Goes first down. First and 10 at the 18-yard line.
They'll run. It's Lindsey. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two. Second and two. First down marker at the 8.
Brings up second and two.
From the gun, Larson escaping the pressure right. And that is caught. Touchdown, Denver. Jerry Jeudy. The second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Broncos add on. His first career touchdown pass, and yeah, it's cliche to say, but he's probably been envisioning this since he was a little kid. That's a cool moment.
It really is. So enjoy the moment, enjoy the time, celebrate, save the full reflection for later, and make sure you grab someone on the sidelines and say, hey, make sure I get back to the ball, okay?
Extra point from McManus is good, and the lead will swell by one more.
Brandon McManus.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Fielded near the back of the end zone, and it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards picking up the first.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. Just one big carry away from busting this open, that's a good start for him.
And the Jets, first down.
On first and 10, Darnold. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. And this is going to be another first down as they'll make the tackle at the Broncos' 38-yard line. Now it looks like we've got a Bronco that's banged up on the play. We'll step aside and get a report when we come back to Denver. Now a first down carry by Bell, fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
A 3-yard pickup brings up second and seven at the Broncos' 35-yard line.
Play action, it's Darnold. Blitz coming, and down he goes. side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Darnold and the Jets come up third and long following the sack. Darnold from the gun. Looking outside, and he's got a man. That's Bell. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. That's going to bring up fourth down, only a gain of two there.
Yeah, certainly playing down in distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. That one sails out of bounds. The side judge will walk it off. And he says it went out of bounds at the 9-yard line. Nice punt. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down to those starters blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the pass.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something, because right now they're just cutting them to shreds.
They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and eight coming up.
Third and eight.
On third down, Larson. He'll find Lindsay here. And brought down, but not before they're able to get it up to the 25. Give him 14 yards there and a Denver first down.
And if anyone thinks they're just going to tuck their horns in and pull back off the throttle a little bit, you can forget it. Even with this big third quarter lead, I think this team's going to continue to take their shots downfield, and there's another completion.
12 more yards there and another first down.
When you enter the game as the AFC Player of the Week award winner, you expect runs like that and then some.
It was fun to watch him in the opener last week in Week 1. He was spectacular. And open for more here in Week 2. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
Down at the 41.
Three quarters in the books. Watching the NFL on EA Sports.
42, Jets 7.
On second down now, it's Briggs. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there.
Taken down.
No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and 6.
It's third down and 6.
Operating from the gun. Larson got a man. It's Judy complete. And he will have the Broncos first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward. On first down, Briggs. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. Now as we look down, it appears we've got a Jet shaking up on the play. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. We'll step aside and get a report when we come back to Denver. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Now it looks like we've got a Bronco that's banged up on the play. And they'll be in search of 6 yards here on third down. This is now the 9th play of the drive. We'll step aside and get a report when we come back to Denver. And he's going to have the hook up to Sutton. Denver has a first down on the 15-yard play.
First and 10 at the 30-yard line.
Going to give this time to the tailback. A gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces, and I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations. There'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Brings up third down.
On third down. It's Briggs, and he picks up the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 16. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. From the gun, Larson. He's got his big tight end, Fant. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. 7 yards, the pickup there. Second and 3 from the 9.
At the Jets' 9-yard line.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. up. Call a no gain that time as it's going to leave him with a third and about three to go.
It's third down and four.
Operating from the gun. Larson, that is caught at the 7 yard line. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, and one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Oh, yeah, being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half. They've got three tight ends here on first and goal to add some extra mass. They'll try to run this one in, and he'll get in. Touchdown, Denver. A great effort there with his second touchdown of the afternoon as his guys continue to put this one out of reach. They seemingly just continue to score at will, and as great as it's been for the offense, you got to feel for that defense down there.
I love that you use the word will, because both teams came into the game with the will to win. But one team has obviously imposed its will on the other and broken them. Because what we're seeing right now, wow, that's a defense that's in tatters after what they faced in this ballgame.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
At their own 18-yard line.
And New York set to take the field. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But somebody, listen, there's some guys that have the casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
Second and 10, Darnold. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on. Third down.
It's third down. And
Darnold now to throw. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. A.J. Bouye with a pick. And he's going to return it to the 21-yard line. Mistake after the interception there. Gosh, you look up at the scoreboard, they just got to be thinking this one cannot get over fast enough.
It certainly can't. And also what happens when you get this big of a deficit, you're supposed to make all the right throws, right? You're supposed to try and obviously get the ball to your own guys. But being down this big, you also take even more chances. And in this situation, that's paid off for them at all.
On the other sideline, jubilation and laughter. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. The Broncos on third down. They're hitting at 60%, 6 out of 10 thus far. This is third and 8. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked by Trayvon Mullen. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Those INTs all sting when you throw one in the red zone. I think especially as a rookie, maybe it stings a little bit more.
I think what you're saying is they don't all count the same, do they? Right? Interceptions in the red zone that you've given up points now, those are precious. So you have to learn from those and in a hurry.
10 yards there to start the drive and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. So first and 10 now from the 30. Now it's Darnold. He'll be brought down by the Broncos. It's a sack.
A loss of 7 yards. It's second down.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, and with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
And it's third
now, Darnold. And Robinson with a big catch. And he is going to have a Jets first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. That's good for a Jet first down, a gain of 13. Pressure now, Darnold, and he goes down. Von Miller, he is the one getting in there. last throw now for Darnold. And he will find his man on the outside. And he'll go out of bounds, it looks like, right at the 40. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. One final shot. They'll look to throw. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in.
Today's
a big offensive explosion of leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for Denver, they use the favorable early schedule to their advantage as they move to 2-0. And they will hit the road next week to take on the L.A. Chargers. Meanwhile, for the Jets, they'll fall to 1-1. And they'll try again next week at home against New England. So for our entire crew, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.